welcome you to the ceremonial announcement of Iihmr and its biggest achievement today. Iihmr was established in 1984 and has completed its 31st year. It is a research, management, education, and a training organization. Another feature that I would want to add here is that Iihmr has recently been conferred as a university from the government of Rajasthan. With this achievement, Iihmr has now become the only health management research university in India. I shall now introduce you to the dignitaries on the dais. To my left, it is Mr. Ashok Agarwal. He is the trustee of Iihmr Society. He is also the director of TCR. Mr. D.K. Agarwal, president of Iihmr University. It is also Dr. S.K. Gupta, the president of Iihmr University. Mr. N.L. Mehta from the Iihmr University. He's the chairperson of the university. And Mr. Ashok Agarwal. He is trustee of Iihmr Society. Mr. S.K. Gupta will now begin with his address and understanding what exactly has Iihmr University contributed. Thank you.
Honorable M.L. Mehta sir, Chancellor of Iihmr University, Sri D.K. Agarwal, Chairman, Management Board, Indian Institute of Health Management Research, Dr. Ashok Agarwal, trustee and founder of Iihmr, my friends from media and press, my faculty colleagues and staff, it's a great honor and a pleasure for me to welcome you all to this press conference. As Sapna introduced, that this is a very special occasion why we are here. We wanted to share with you a very important development. And that important development is that a university named Iihmr University has come into existence in Jaipur. It's a great pleasure to announce that Iihmr University is launched and is already functional. The origin of this Iihmr University is embedded in its parent institution, Indian Institute of Health Management Research, which was working for the last 30 years and contributed very significantly at the national and international level. Not only in the area of policy research and strategic management and program management in the health sector, but also capacity building. A very important thing that Iihmr could do was to start a program on hospital and health management, MBA program in hospital and health management in 1996. Which is now ranked number one in the country, consistently for last 12 years. And this is perhaps the only program where all the seats are filled and the placement is 100% on the campus. So that with that, the institute grew up very fast, but it has taken 30 years to come this stage that we are now a university. What this university will do? It will continue to carry the legacy of its predecessor, Iihmr, which has contributed so significantly, not only in research and education, but also capacity building. The distinction goes with Iihmr is this, that it created a new discipline called health management, which did not exist at all anywhere in the world. We are very proud that it started in Jaipur, it started in Rajasthan, and it started in India. That we brought in a very new discipline of health management. And not only we brought this discipline of health management, this institute is primarily a research institute. So research in health management, focused on public health, health services, health systems, hospital, and policy was the major initiative that was taken by us. So first 10 years after its inception in 1984, we focused exclusively on research in policy and program management. Subsequently, we started this postgraduate program in hospital health management, which became India's number one program. And then in a big way, management skill development of policy makers and health program managers in this country. And it became a WHO's collaborating center for its contribution. I want to share with you that this is a unique organization which has come all the way and made a significant contribution. I want to share with you that what we see today, that the polio has been eradicated. You might be surprised, you know, and it could be a pleasant surprise that we had a role in that. In 1998, we did extensive strategic review of polio eradication activities and suggested a new model and approach to eradication. And then that was accepted by the WHO and Government of India. And today, very happy and proud to say that polio is eradicated from India. So we are very proud to say that we contributed in that. We also participated and developed strategies for AIDS control in India. So National AIDS Control Program Phase 2 and Phase 3 were strategized and evaluated by IIHMR. Similarly, this leprosy, today leprosy is eliminated, and IIHMR evaluated National Leprosy Evaluation Program and gave information to WHO and Government of India that leprosy levels have gone so low that it will not be further transmitted. That is by definition called elimination. Leprosy is now declared eliminated from India. So we have made immense contribution. We have made immense contribution in Rajasthan itself. This health systems development project, which was about 500 crore rupees project, which was conceptualized and developed, and we helped the government of Rajasthan to implement this project. We helped in many other ways. And the state to develop policies and program management for effective delivery of care. Currently, we are doing a very important work on the 3-4 things that we are doing, and after that, I will stop. The presentation is already there, so you can have a look at that, and maybe the copies of this presentation will be given to you. We are currently running a very important project. That is food fortification project. What does it mean? Our women and children are anemic. And the government has a program to distribute iron folic acid tablets for women and children. But this we are doing for the last 50 years. And we have not been able to reduce anemia among women. IHMR, with the support of Yale, this is an organization, is now adopting a very rural approach for fortification of wheat flour with iron, which is consumed by everyone, and that should help reduce anemia. We are also fortifying our milk with vitamin A and D through Rajasthan Dairy Packaging Corporation. You will be surprised how much of milk every day we fortify. 1.7 million liters of milk is fortified with vitamin A and D and distributed throughout the state. Similarly, we are fortifying now oil of all types, whether mustard oil or soya oil, and distributed not only in Rajasthan but all outside Rajasthan also to reduce micronutrient deficiencies. It's a pilot project. If we succeed, it will be scaled up in India and in the developing countries. So we are learning lessons from that. Another project that we are doing these days is health of urban poor. You might be knowing urban health is a major issue. आपको मालूम होगा कि गांवों में प्राइमरी हेल्थ सेंटर्स हैं, बहुत बड़ा नेटवर्क है गांवों के लिए, पर अर्बन एरिया में या शहरों में अगर आपने देखा होगा कि आप अपने बच्चे को टीका लगवाने जाएं तो कहाँ जाएं? प्राइवेट डॉक्टर के पास है, अस्पताल में, आप बीमार हो जाए तो अस्पताल जाए। आपके स्वास्थ्य के बारे में अर्बन एरिया में कोई पॉलिसी नहीं। अभी 2013 में भारत सरकार ने अर्बन हेल्थ के ऊपर भी फोकस करना शुरू किया, लेकिन हमने तीन साल पहले एक प्रोजेक्ट शुरू किया कि अब अर्बन हेल्थ मैनेजमेंट को हम समझें कि यह है क्या और इसको कैसे स्ट्रेटजीज बनाए। उस पायलट प्रोजेक्ट से बहुत से लेसन्स हमने लर्न किए हैं जो राष्ट्रीय शहरी स्वास्थ्य कार्यक्रमों में सहायक हो गए। आप ICDS के बारे में जानते हैं, उनमें से 76 से ICDS कार्यक्रम चल रहा है बच्चों के स्वास्थ्य के लिए, न्यूट्रिशन के लिए। और कितना मेल न्यूट्रिशन कम हुआ ये तो इससे पता चलता है कि अभी भी मेल न्यूट्रिशन उतना ही है बच्चों में, कुपोषण।